Hello everyone, Danas here with ActionVFX. In this After Effects tutorial, I'm going to give you an introduction to PowerMesh in Mocha Pro. PowerMesh is a feature that allows you to track organic surfaces,
such as human skin or clothing.
That way you can do effects such as adding logos on a shirt or a texture effects on a human skin, like I have shown you in some of my tutorials. This PowerMesh feature can only be found in the plugin Mocha Pro by Boris Effects, which is the advanced version of Mocha AE. We actually partnered with our friends from Boris Effects to offer an exclusive discount of Mocha Pro, so you want to stay tuned to learn more. Oh, before we begin, do you love free ActionVFX elements? Well, we have good news for you. We just launched our new Free for Subscribers initiative on our website, where if you are subscribed to the ActionVFX subscription from the basic plan and up, you will have access to over 1,000 of our premium assets for free. All you have to do is just sign up for the ActionVFX subscription and you have all these assets ready for you. More info about this in the description below. Anyway, without further ado, let's go to the tutorial. Okay, so this is the plate that we will be tracking. This plate is from FilmPAC.com and they are kind enough to let us share this plate for free to you in the description below. So we want to track this side of the face and a little bit of the neck. That way we can stick a textured element that not only tracked into the scene but also stretches along when his mouth opens and other skin stretches. So let's search our Mocha Pro plugin, not Mocha AE, and drag it into the plate. And notice we have more stuff on our drop-down menu here than the regular Mocha AE. So now let's click on the logo and go to Mocha. Now, in Mocha Pro, I'm not going to go over the basics of tracking. You can find that in our previous tutorial on the introduction to Mocha. So, I will jump straight to the PowerMesh. First, of course, we want to find a reference frame, which is the frame where we see the most of the skin, or essentially the base frame where we will do our VFX element and then track it. So, you want to find a frame where the surface that you want to track is very visible and laid out. Here, pretty much all the frames are good as a reference frame, but I want to pick one at the very end because here we have our neck exposed and not covered by the color, and the cheek is also stretched out a bit so we can see a bit more of the skin, but not too much that it creates a wrinkle around the mouth. So now, let's grab an area that we want to track. I want to make sure that the spline is near the edges but still inside the talon. And I want to exclude facial features like the ear, mouth, and eyes, and the nose. Now, we cannot just do a regular planar track here, because we want to track the stretch and squash of the skin. So on the track tab and motion, check the perspective, and also mesh. So now our power mesh is activated, and our spline here is now broken up into these sub-planar surfaces. And the track combination of all these triangles here will result in the surface warping. Currently, our generation mode is set as automatic, which means it's in the shape of these random triangles. So this style of mesh breakup is good for smooth surfaces or bare skin, but for things like faces or shirt, it is advisable to switch it to uniform. So now let's generate mesh. And now we have our spline broken up in a different way, this time into these little squares. So now we can capture a more detailed areas on our face. If we zoom in here and let's turn on and off our mesh, we see that some of the points are inside of the spline while some others are outside. And that is fine because only the points that are inside of the spline will be tracking. So the points that are outside works as essentially a backup pixel. We can also play around with the size of these square surfaces. Maybe you want to track bigger areas on each of the sub-planar surface. So we can change this to say 100 and generate. And now we have bigger squares. But for this shot, the default 32 works just fine. You can also turn on this edit track mesh and manually move the points if need to. Maybe you want to drag in the points that are outside to be inside or vice versa. And then you can also click add track mesh vertices to add new points to your mesh. Okay, so everything is looking nice. Now let's hit track. And there we go. We have a nice looking track that records the squash and stretches of the skin. However, around here we see that the color is crossing into our power mesh. We can fix that by manually animating the track mesh grid. So let's add a keyframe just before the track goes wonky and then manually move it. Or an easier way to handle this is to use a holdout mat. So first let's rename this. And we want to disable the view and disable the process gear here so we don't accidentally retract it again. And then we want to create a shape for our color and name it holdout mat. And I want to start tracking this and make sure the spline is always covering the color. Okay, now we want to make sure our color holdout layer is on top of our mesh track. Now let's turn on our mesh track layer again. And I want to disable the process gear icon of the holdout mat. Now let's select our mesh track layer. So now what we want to do is we want to retract this power mesh. We can do the retracking just before the wonkiness happens, but just to be extra safe, I want to retract it from the start. So let's track. And perfect. So now, thanks to the holdout mat, the power mesh is ignoring the color as it comes up. And we have our track, which is looking really good. Okay, so before we add our elements, we want to first go to the stabilize panel. And essentially, we want to verify our reference frame. So I want to go to the reference frame here. And we want to click on the frame list. And then click on mesh warp. And if we check on mesh warp, we see how it looks when we stabilize our track. So now that we have this, let's close and save. If you're enjoying this tutorial so far, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and like this video because your support means a lot to us and we want to keep making cool tutorials like this one. And now, let's go back to the video. So to add texture elements into the track, there are actually two ways to do it. First is the more elaborate workflow using pre-comps, which I have done in many of my tutorials that uses PowerMesh. And the second one is essentially the easier way of doing it, using the insert module that came in with Mocha Pro 2022. So I'm going to start by covering the elaborate workflow first, and then after that, we're going to cover the insert module. Okay, so first we want to duplicate our plate here, complete with the Mocha Pro. And then on the duplicate, we're gonna go to the Mocha effects and we're gonna go to the model renders and we want to click on render. And then we want to change this to stabilize on warp. So now you can see that our plate is being stabilized based on our reference frame. So what we'll do is we want to add our elements on top here and then rewarp or unstabilized everything back to make them track into the scene. So now what I want to do is I want to precompose our duplicate that has been stabilized and let's name this texture elements and we want to move all the attributes and okay. Now let's go inside the precomp and we want to change our plate inside the precomp into a guide layer. That way this plate will only exist on this precomposition as a reference plate, but it will not be rendered out outside of this. Next, we're going to add the textures elements that we want to have on our skin. So I want to bring in this texture file precomp that I have. So this grid is only just a placeholder image just to give me a better visual of the skin track. And the reason why I use a precomp instead of just a PNG file is that I want to be able to just swap around the elements later. So I can just go into the texture file precomp here and I can just disable the grid and replace it with something else like this bleeding moon asset. And if we go back to our texture elements precomp, it will be updated. So this grid is just a placeholder. So now of course our grid here is a bit too flat. So I wanted to make it follow the curvature and contour of the head. That way it would look like it's really sitting on the skin. So I'm going to use a mesh warp and using that, I want to start warping the image to fit the contour of the face. Now of course if you just want to track a single image frame instead of like a video, you can just do this contouring in Photoshop and then save out as a single image. But because I want to have the possibility to track in a video footage on the skin like the bleeding moon, I'm doing this in After Effects. Okay, so this is looking pretty good. We can see the curvature of the chin here and also a little bit of the neck. So now let's go back to the main comp. And then what we want to do is to destabilize our stabilized elements here. So let's copy and paste the Mocha Pro effects from the plate to our pre-comp. And then on the module renders, let's check in render again. And we want to switch this from stabilize on warp to stabilize warp. So now if we scrub through here, we have our grid sitting tracking on the face. So then of course, we want to mat our texture here. Of course, we can do some manual roto inside of this pre-comp, or we can go back to the main comp again and go to mat and use the spline that we created. Then let's feather it a bit. After this, we could just disable the grid and start compositing the actual element that we want to have. Okay, so that was how I did it in my previous tutorials. Now I'm going to show you how to do all of that much faster using the insert module. So this is our composition again, but this time we have our texture layer not yet tracked and it doesn't have any Mocha on it. So let's go back to our plate and then on the original Mocha Pro effects, let's go to our module renders and we want to go to insert layer and select our texture as the insert layer. And then let's go to Mocha. Now inside of Mocha, we want to select our mesh track layer and then we want to go to insert and we want to select our insert layer as our insert clip. And there we go. We have our texture being brought into Mocha. But it's looking really small because of the size of our planar surface here. So we can resize it by doing it manually, of course. Or we can go to our reference frame and then we want to expand it to fill the entire frame. There we go. Now we are back to where we were in After Effects. Next, and this is important, let's go to our insert tab and in comp, we want to turn on PowerMesh. So now our texture is tracked. We're back in business. You can do a lot of things as well here. Like for example, you can turn on the grid warp here. And by using the grid warp, we can do the mesh warping inside of Mocha here. So instead of doing it in After Effects using mesh warp or in Photoshop, we can just do this directly in Mocha. And then you can change the blending mode as well to help with your compositing or maybe even reduce the opacity. So now that we have our texture tracked into the plate, let's close and save. Now back in After Effects, let's disable our texture elements here. And then we want to bring back all the things that we just did inside of Mocha to here. So on the module renders, let's click render. And on the module, we want to select either insert composite or insert cutout. So insert composite essentially just bring what we had in Mocha and baked it into our layer. Now we have our grid here with the tracking and everything all inside of this one plate layer. So if you want to make some changes, you can go back to Mocha or you can also play around with the settings here like the blend modes. You can also change it here or the opacity. Another thing that you can do as well to get you a bit more flexibility is to switch the insert composite to insert cutout. So now we have removed our plate and just have our texture with again already have the tracking data attached. So then what we can do is to go to mat and use our mat here and then let's bring back our plate below our texture and this is what we have. Perfect. So now what we can do is to go back to the texture precom and let's switch the grid to your elements. And bada bing bada boom, we have our shot. So now of course we can just replace the grid with other textures or video footage. Like for example, I replaced the grid with this bleeding wound element or maybe use a gore texture that you can get for free if you are an ActionVFX subscriber. Or you can check out my other tutorials on what kind of other effects that you can do with PowerMesh. And now you're probably wondering, how can I get this fancy Mocha Pro plugin? Well, you're in luck because we have partnered with our friends at BorisFX to give you an exclusive 20% discount on our favorite planner tracking plugin. All you have to do is to go to the link on the description below and use the coupon code ActionVFX-Mocha2022. And once you have your Mocha Pro, you're going to need some VFX elements to be tracked into your shot. And you can get those elements anytime at ActionVFX.com. At ActionVFX, we provide vast library of high-quality VFX stock footage for your projects. From fire and smoke, energy effects and explosions, and many, many others. You can purchase them directly or sign up to our subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library, including our subscribers-only free collections, and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. I encourage you to drop a like and let us know in the comment section below what kind of tutorials that you'd like to see next. But most of all, be sure to subscribe. We are aiming for 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year. And also, there are other resources on this channel, such as other VFX tutorials, podcasts, VFX breakdowns, and many others. So be sure to check them out as well. Let us be your number one resource for visual effects. So, see you next time. Bye-bye.